Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I am Priyanka and you're watching Miss Priyanka YouTube channel. So today I'm going to be sharing my Diwali makeup look with you guys. And so before we start the makeup tutorial, I want to wish you all a very happy Diwali and lots of joy this Diwali. So enjoy your day and have lots of fun, eat lots of sweets. And now, yes, let's get started. So Diwali celebration happens most of the time in evening. So considering the occasion and the evening thing, I'm going to be creating a makeup look according to that. And also for any kind of evening look, I think smoky eyes look so flattering, and nothing can look much more elegant than a smoky eyes. So going to be doing that today. And of course, when you do your own makeup and you try to create any kind of eye makeup, of course, so girls, make sure that you always keep your outfit color in mind, because Indian outfit, the sari and the lehengas are all about colors and the detailing over the dress. Maybe it could be a gold detailing, the jari work, or it can be silver detailing or pearl. So make sure that you consider the detailing as well as the color of your outfit, maybe your blouse color, or maybe you know, the chunni color, you can say. So considering all these colors, you can create eye makeup look and decide the shades that you want to add to your makeup look. So yes, it's evening occasion, of course we are getting ready for a Diwali party, and considering all of these things in mind, I think for evening look you can either keep your eyes bold or you can keep your lips bold. But if you want to keep your eyes and lips both presentable, then of course you can do both, because it's evening event, like I told, and you will be carrying the makeup from evening to the night. And of course, in between all those lightings and your outfit, the makeup will stand out. So don't restrict yourself, try whatever you like. So yes, I will try to create the smoky eye look, because I'm wearing a beautiful black sari, which is my favorite. It does has these silver detailing on it. So I'm going to be creating smoky eye look that will be complementing my outfit, as well as evening look. Of course, we will be taking lots of selfie and pictures. So let's get started. I'm super excited to do the look. So I already added the lip balm to my lips and my face is moisturized. So because I'm getting ready for a special occasion, I'm going to be using my MAC concealer today. So I'm going to be wearing this shade all over my eyelid as my eyeshadow base. So that's the step one that you need to do. With my fingers, I'll dab it all across my eyelid. So you can see the difference. So make sure you apply very thin layer of this concealer, because it's full coverage cream based concealer. So you don't need to layer it a lot of the product. So yes, I'm done with that. I'm gonna set my concealer with a little bit compact. You can use any powder to set the eyeshadow base very lightly. Okay, so that's the step two, like set your concealer. And so now step number three is take any of your gel eyeliner, or also you can use any of your kajal pencil. So firstly, I'll draw a line. Firstly, I will trace my natural crease. I will put a mark here. This is my natural crease. Likewise, I'll do to the other eye. Roughly, you need to do that. Okay. Okay, so now then you got the trace. And then blend it in like so. So it will create a very tacky, creamy and sticky base. That's the reason I used gel eyeliner over my eyelid, so that if I work with black eyeshadow, it will stick to my eyelid. It won't, you know, keep on falling over my face. In case if you don't do that, your eyelid is already dry and it will not stick the eyeshadows, the powder eyeshadow that you place over the eyelid. So that's the logic, and that's why I'm doing that. So I'm just blending the crease of the black eyeshadow, and I'm just moving it upside like this. I'm using the same blending brush, the flat tip brush. Okay, so whatever is left in the brush, I'll just place this on my lower lash line like so. Okay, so that's how I just added a shape to my eyes. So you can see the black gel eyeliner has outlined my eyelid, and this is something that defines the size of my eyes. So if your eyes shape is already big, then you don't need to go over a bit, or you don't need to put thick kajal or liner to the lower lash lines, because it will make your eyes look too big and black. So we don't want that. We just want to neutralize the eye shape if you have already too big eyes, just by enhancing it. If your eye shapes are like me, hooded eyes, then of course you can go and extend the shape of your eyes a little bit like so, like you can see. So next step, I will apply black eyeshadow all across my eyelid wherever I applied the black gel eyeliner. So I'm going to be working with black eyeshadow, and this eyeshadow does have some silver glitters in it, very tiny glitters, which I love because it's matching with my dress. So I'm going to be doing the same eyeshadow from Sephora makeup palette. I'm going to be placing it all across my lid like so. So can you see that silver sparkle in it? I'll do the other eye. Guys, make sure that you always work very closer to your lash lines. It's very important that no skin should be visible through your eye makeup. Of course, you need to cover every single corner of your eyelid, especially to the closer to the lash line. So that's what I'm focusing more upon on that. I will take some black eyeshadow and put it to the lower lash line likewise. So now I will just quickly clean my face so that there is no extra eyeshadow left over. Okay. So next step is take any deep brown eyeshadow, and you need to place that black over the line of these black eyeshadows. So I'm going to be showing you that. You can take any kind of pencil brush so that you have these pointed tips and you can work in the direction that you want. So I will start from the outer corner and I'll just outline the black eyeshadow, the ends of these black eyeshadow over the crease. I'm just blending this with black eyeshadow only to the crease area so that everything looks soft and looks like I have a beautiful gradient effect from black to deep brown to the light brown. I think I'm done with the deep brown shade. Over that, I'm going to work with light brown shade, and again I will be using the pencil tip brush, or you can use the same pencil tip brush, but make sure that you clean it nicely so that both the color doesn't mix, and the light brown shade, as you can see here. So this is my second brown color that I'm going to be using for this eye look. So I will place this color again over the deep brown shade and blending the edges of all these eyeshadows, like you can see. Very easy, very simple. Just you need to understand what are the steps that you need to do by your own. So yeah. Likewise, the other eye. Let me check in my phone how it looks. Okay, so now I will blend the outer edges and my crease line with a neat, clean, fluffy brush so that everything looks neat, blended and softened. So yes, I'm gonna do that. I'll take some brown eyeshadow and I will apply it to the lower lash line so that it also looks blended. It'll add nice gradient effect to my lower lashes, lash line of course. So I think the eyeshadow is nicely blended, and after sometimes, you know, until you do your base, it's always happened that everything's get absorbed into your skin and melted to your skin. So likewise, I think it will get blended automatically. I mean, after some time it gets settled. So if needed, then I will again blend it. But for now, I'm okay with this. And now I will add some glitters on my eyelid, which is the fun part, because of course I have the silver detailing on it. And right now my eyes are into a matte black eye look. Although there are some silvery sparkle in it, but that is very tiny bit. So I will add some silver glitters to it. So I'm going to be wearing this glitter. So I'm just putting it only to the centers of my eyelid, moving it towards the inner corner. Okay. I'm going to do same to the other eye. So for glitters, you don't need to do similar what I am doing. You can use any glitter that is matching to your dress color and try to put it on the eyelid. Of course, that will stand out because your base is black, so it will pop up, and that will add, that will enhance the eye makeup look and make you look more glamorous. And yeah, it will look like you have a really nice eye makeup, and also photogenic it looks. So yes, you can do that. So I want to keep the look a little bit subtle side. I mean, not the whole thing is I don't want to make the look too sparkly. I just want to add a little beauty to it, not too much, you know. I hope you understand. So, and I will tight line and put the kajal to the waterline. So I'm wearing this Maybelline kajal pencil. It's the Lasting Drama gel eyeliner pencil. So I will firstly tight line. Okay, so I'm done with the kajal, and next step I will put eyeliner. I will create tiny wings like this. Okay, I think I did a good job. Done. And okay, so now I will do my eyebrows, and I will be wearing this Music Flower gel eyeliner, and this is in the shade brown, and I will use this gel eyeliner to fill in my eyebrows. That's how I prefer. It's a beautiful deep brown liner. Combing my eyebrows. So the tips I have shared in the video, you try to follow that, and I'm sure it will work for you guys as well. Yes, sometimes practice matters, but if you just put some effort and time, of course you can achieve the similar look for your eye shape. So yeah, that's all, and enjoy your smoky eyes. So, and I will try to clean the edges of the eyebrows. So I'll precisely clean the edges of my eyebrows with the same MAC concealer. And I'm just blending the edges. So guys, eye makeup is done, only the eyelashes is left and brow bone to highlight. And now I will clean all these fallouts from my face. So I will take some moisturizer on a cotton pad and I will clean my face. So I just cleaned my face with the moisturizer and my face is already moisturized. And what I want to do, I will just seal my eyeshadow once with MAC Prep and Prime spray, setting spray. So we're gonna do that first. I'll let it dry for 2 minutes. Okay, so I did this one because I really don't want the eyeshadows to be falling out on my face while doing my makeup, because still the shadows are fresh, it has not absorbed into my skin, so there are chances that it will fall on my face. So this spray will set that eyeshadow, the powdery part, and lock it on place. So very important. This will also work as my primer, and I will straight away start with the foundation and concealer. So for foundation, I'm going to be wearing the Sephora 10R long wear foundation. So yes, I took it on the back of my hand and I will put a very thin layer of foundation on my entire face. I really don't want to go with very thick and layered makeup, so I'll take it and blend it on my face like so. This gives a very natural finish to my face. Okay, so now then I'm done with my foundation, let it set for some time, and I'm going to be using the same MAC concealer with a small tip brush. I'm going to apply it under my eyes. So I'll work with this yellow tone concealer and I will highlight my face a little bit, only to the center part, like my chin somewhat, then upper lips, sides of my lips, bridge of my nose. I'm not going too much. I'm going to take the foundation brush and blend it everywhere and everywhere. So immediately after wearing the concealer, I will set it with some compact and I will put it like so. Okay. I'm using the Sephora compact to set my concealer. So you don't need to literally put a lot of powder under your eyes and make your eyes look, you know, cakey and dry. So don't do all these things. Just try to work with a good high coverage concealer. Make sure that it is creamy in texture, and always use pressed powder because it just locks up your concealer instead of using loose powder to set your concealer. Okay, now I will set my entire face with the same compact. Very lightly, I will dust the powder all across my face. So I think the foundation is done and I think my face looks a little bit flat to the outer sides. Also, the shape of my face is a little rounder, so I always like to add some bronzing effect to my face. So for that, I'm going to be using this Sephora contouring palette, and it has these two beautiful brown shades. So I always like to mix these two shades and put it on my sides of my face so that my face get a little bit warmed up and looks like I do have shadows. I will also add a little bit of depth to my nose so that it looks sharp and nice. Okay, so the base looks really natural, looks like I have my own skin, and it looks like my skin is showing through the makeup but still nicely done, which I like about the look, and I really achieved that, I think so. And now I'm gonna be doing my blush, highlighter and lipstick. So firstly, we will be doing lipstick. After selecting the lipstick, we can decide the blush, because your lipstick and your blush should be matching. I mean, the undertone of the blush. If you're wearing pink, try to wear pink blush. If you're wearing red, try to wear the blush with redness in it. So I'm wearing black color outfit, so I'm going to be wearing red lipstick. And firstly, I will outline my lips. So I will start with lining my lips. So it's done. And for lipstick, I'm going to be wearing this waterproof lipstick by NYX, and it is in the shade FTLS04. So done with the lipstick, and since I wore the red lipstick, I'm going to be wearing the blush which has red undertone to it. Oh, I'm going to be wearing this matte red eyeshadow. This is the red color. So I will take the color on my brush and then I will put it on my hands, and then I will slightly run on my cheeks. So guys, can you see the blush that I have created? It's just matching with my lip color and does have this redness in it. That you can actually, when you click the pictures, you will be able to see that. Also, it looks more subtle. Very lightly, I'm just touching my cheeks because it's red color, so I don't want some to my jawline, forehead. I think this much plus is enough. A little to my nose. I want to wear the highlighter which has silver undertone to it. The glitters and the sparkle needs to be towards the silver side, not to the gold side. So gonna be wearing this highlighter. This is, you can see the shade, so I'm gonna be wearing it on my face. Add some to my forehead and my chin. Because this highlighter is in silver shade, so it will add a silverish finish to my face, or it will, I can say, it will give you like a pearl glow to your face, because I have all this silver detail in my dress. And now I will highlight my brow bone and also my inner corner with the same highlighter. So the makeup is already done, and then I will add some false eyelashes. It's completely optional. If you want, you can wear just a good coat of mascara, and if you want to add some more drama to the look and make it look more glamorous, of course you can add the lashes to your makeup. And now I will do my hairs, and then I will come back and show you the final look. final look after getting my hair done. I just did some soft curl and just tucked my hair like that so that it looks a little bit done. And very quick, I did the hair styling. I added these bracelets, and I'm not going to be wearing any necklace, any jewelry, because already my outfit is shining and my makeup is bold, towards little bold side. So yes, that's all for the look, and I think the look turned out really well, perfect for Diwali. If you are wearing saris especially, or wearing very heavy detailed lehenga if you're newly married, or of course there is wedding season coming ahead, so you can try out the look for. So yeah, that's all for the look, and I really love the way it turned out. This is more of like me, because I love wearing makeup. But wearing makeup doesn't mean that you layer a lot of makeup. It means that wear the makeup for right occasion, right outfit, and in a right way. And if you have any queries related to the makeup, or any confusion related, or if you have any request or suggestions or any opinion about the look, comment down below and let me know how I am looking, the whole outfit, makeup, and the vibes of Diwali. So yeah, that's all. Have fun, eat lots of sweets, and enjoy, and yeah, that's all. I will see you soon in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye guys.